Hello guys, this lesson focuses on swallowing maneuvers during dysphagia management process. In this series, we are going to be demonstrating different swallowing maneuvers which are necessary before subjecting the patient to solid or liquid swallows. Activity 1, supraglottic swallow. This activity tends to increase airway protection and reduces the chances of aspiration during swallowing process. While patients sit in upright position, encourage patient to collect saliva, inhale deeply and hold breath, swallow the saliva while holding the breath, cough immediately in order to release the breath. Activity 2, Medalsin maneuver. During this process, encourage patient to take a deep breath followed by swallowing. While swallowing, ask patient to hold the thyroid notch in a raised position for 3 seconds or continue to practice on the patient can hold the thyroid notch up to 3 seconds. You can do this activity for up to 30 repetitions. The third activity is the Masako swallowing maneuvers. To practice this, ask patient to stick out the tongues between the teeth and the lips. Hold firmly and swallow. Make sure the tongues dissolve throughout the process. Do this for up to 10 times or as recommended by your therapist. Activity 4, chin down posture. While seated in upright position, encourage neck flexion followed by immediate swallow. Head back in mid position. This activity can be repeated for up to 10 times. Reverse the process by putting the head in extension position and encourage patient to swallow while maintaining that position. Observe the thyroid notch elevation and make sure you facilitate the process if there is need. The fifth activity is known as Shakel exercise. This exercise can be performed in 3 different ways. 1. We have sustained Shakel exercise, followed by repetitive Shakel exercise and alternative repetitive Shakel exercise. The purpose of clarity, we will start with sustained Shakel exercise. During this process, maintain patient in supine position, encourage neck flexion by asking the patient to touch the chest using the chin, hold the position for up to 60 seconds, then relax the head back into neutral position. This exercise can be practiced for up to 10 times or as recommended by the therapist. 2. Repetitive Shakel exercise. While patient maintains supine position, encourage chin to chest or neck flexion. Hold the position for 1 second, followed by relaxation of the neck in mid plane for 1 second. Practice this for up to 30 times. During this process, make sure the patient is not using any supportive pillow as the shoulder must be flat throughout the entire process. Please note, the purpose of the Shakel exercise is to assist with laryngeal elevation, opening of the upper esophageal sphincter, and decreasing pharyngeal residuals. 3. Alternative repetitive Shakel exercise. Note, the alternative repetitive version of Shakel exercise requires you to have a small stress ball. While maintaining upright sitting position, lock your arm against your side, place the ball under your chin, gradually press it down with your chin on the ball, hold the ball in position for 1 second, make sure you repeat the sequence for up to 30 times. With this, we have come to the end of our series 5. Hope to see you in our next series, which focuses on food and water placement maneuvers during dysphagia.